Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the GA series brought to you by EduTab. So today in this lecture we are going to cover March 11th to 14th, and let me tell you that the series related to general awareness is important if you are preparing for RBA Grade B, NABARD Grade A or SEBI Grade A of 2019, and also it is going to be helpful in the preparation for the assistant exams of RBI and NABARD both. So let me tell you about our previous results. See, we have been working in this field from quite some time now. We have some brilliant results with us. You can see here 27 selections in RBI Grade B of 2017 and 11 selections in NABARD Grade A. And 2018, if talking about the results, RBI Grade B, the results were announced recently and 70 plus of our students have been selected. And NABARD Grade A, 26 selections were made. And about the SEBI Grade A of 2018, let me tell you that more than 150 of our students have gone through the interview phase. So here also we have a brilliant result, you can see. Now let me tell you about our courses which are being offered. So these are the individual courses. You can choose from any of these courses as per your requirement: RBI Grade B, SEBI, NABARD, RBI Assistant, and we have also launched the IBBS AFO course. And if you are preparing for two or more exams simultaneously, then you can go for the combo courses. Herein, again, you have so many options. You can choose as per your requirement. So, okay, so here is the good news for you guys. We have come up with a new course which is related to your all the banking examinations. So QRE, quantitative aptitude, reasoning and English is covered comprehensively in this banking course, and you can opt for this course. So that is it about our courses. So let us come back to your lecture of the day and let us start with your GA section news starting from March 11th. Okay, so your very first news is about the launch of the Pulse Polio program for the year 2019. You can see in the picture here, our president is launching this Pulse Polio program by administering polio drops to the children. So these drops are actually administered to the children who are less than 5 years of age, and more than 70 crore children of less than 5 years of age would go through this particular Pulse Polio program drive. I will tell you, this is very important because in 2014, India was declared to be a polio free country. So as to maintain this status, it is very important because we have achieved it. That is a great thing. And now we have to maintain that also. So this was the polio eradication program which was launched, and at various levels it is administered. So that is it about your Pulse Polio program. Okay, so the joint military exercise between India and Oman has commenced. See, we are covering different bilateral exercise. In the in our previous video also we covered the India and Bangladesh bilateral military exercise. So here the exercise is about India and Oman. So the exercise is called as Al Naga 3. So the year 2019, the India and Oman, they have started this military exercise in Oman only. So the regiment headquarters of Oman, the place where this exercise is taking place. So from Indian sides, Gadwal rifles went to the exercise, and from the army of Oman, Jabail regiment took the initiative. So this is all about your military exercise. Keep in mind, make a note of all the important bilateral exercises. Okay, so India bags first prize at the International Golden City Gate Tourism Awards. So these are the International Tourism Awards, and Ministry of Tourism of the Government of India has won the first prize. So that is important for us, and that is the reason we are covering this news here. So in the category of TV cinema spot at the prestigious this Golden City Gate Tourism Awards, Indian Ministry of Tourism has won the first prize. So these are actually the about the awards also. You can read here, these are the multimedia awards. They are given in the various categories, and this ceremony actually takes place at Berlin. So in Germany basically takes place, wherein it is a proud moment for us that our ministry has won the first prize. Keep the category also in mind about this TV cinema spot. Okay, so India has successfully completed the trials of guided Pinaka rockets. So DRDO has test fired guided Pinaka rockets. We have seen about this Pokhran ranges. Most of the tests are conducted here only. There are also this air show which had taken place in the Pokhran range. So this weapon system is important. Pinaka is actually developed indigenously. That is, it is developed by DRDO and it is equipped with the advanced navigation and control system. So basically boosting the capability of the army, of the artillery of the army, this guided Pinaka missile is targeted. So keep in mind about this Pinaka missile, which has been developed by DRDO. So March 14th is being celebrated as the World Kidney Day. So the theme for the year 2019 is Kidney Health for Everyone Everywhere. This is the theme, and since March 14th is celebrated at the world level, so some initiatives were also taken by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare of India. So various campaign programs were launched at making people aware about the importance of their kidneys. So the day is important and theme is anyways important for us. So that is it. Okay, another missile is here. Man portable anti-tank missile has been tested again. See, we have covered anti-tank guided missiles earlier, but as you can see, this is the man portable. So that means man can actually carry these missiles. So in the picture, you can see here. So they have been test fired. They were developed by DRDO again. So Pinaka is also developed, that is not man portable. Keep in mind. So this one is man portable and its name is also this only, MPATGM. That is man portable. Anti-tank guided missile. So you must not be confused now between Pinaka and this man portable missile. So again in the Rajasthan desert it has been tested, and this was the second and final test which has been made, and now it will be it is ready for the incorporation in the Indian Army. So because these missiles are actually developed by DRDO indigenously, so these are more important for us. They are enhancing the capability of Indian Army and our artillery. So that is it about this news. Okay, a very important report has been recently released, Global Environmental Outlook Report. So United Nations has come up with this report. It is the flagship report of United Nations. The United Nations Environment, this is the flagship report, and this is the sixth edition of this report. And some important findings of this report I have mentioned here, though we are not going to cover up the entire report here, just to know that what this report is all about. Then who organizes, which organization has come up with this report, and what is the theme actually. So you can see here that report says that governments can actually put the world on the path to a truly sustainable future. So as sustainable development goals, we have talked about them, 17 SDGs are there, 2030 is the target year for them to be achieved, and we are fast approaching 2030. So Global Environment Outlook report is also pointing in the same direction. So an urgent action is required as per the report, and also the actions have to be inclusive. So that means that the actions should not be taken only by the developed nations. Also the developing nations should be incorporated, even the ones the poor nations should also be included here. So SDGs are mentioned in this report again, and Paris Agreement, which was recently signed, has also been appreciated in this report. So that is it. See, this is the sixth edition, but this is not an annual report. You have to know that first edition was released in the year 1997. So from 1997 till 2019, six editions of Global Environmental Outlook report have come. Okay, so this is your last news of the lecture. Let us see what is it about. So India has awarded Golden Jubilee scholarships to the Nepali students. Before proceeding to this news, are you able to recall the scholarship in the name of Mahatma Gandhi, which was given to the students of Sri Lanka? That also we had covered earlier. So this one is about the Nepali students. So Embassy of India has awarded in Kathmandu, Nepal, has awarded 200 Golden Jubilee scholarships to the students of Nepal, and this is actually the scholarship has started in 2002, and from then we are offering these scholarships to the Nepali students. So you can read here that What is the amount of scholarship which is paid to them for MBBS or BDS students? 4,000 rupees per month given for 5 years. BE student, it is 4,000, and for the students in other undergraduate programs, it is 3,000. So that is it about the scholarship. And we are done with your news. So let us try to solve your MCQs. I would recommend you guys to pause your video and then try to answer the question. Okay, Al Naga is a joint military exercise between India and which of the following countries? So which country is it? Yemen, Nepal, Syria, Oman or Bangladesh? So our answer to this question is Oman, because Al Naga we have just covered. It is a military exercise between India and Oman. Okay, World Kidney Day is celebrated on which of the following days? So the answer to this question is March 14th. Question 3. Golden Jubilee scholarships have been awarded to the students of which of the following countries? So the scholarship is mentioned here. So it is easy for you to identify. Golden Jubilee scholarship has gone to the students of Nepal. And your final question. Global Environment Outlook report is released by which of the following organizations? This is very important. You have to know the releasing body, the theme, if there is any such key findings also. So these are all the international NGOs which are working in this field of environment. But our answer to this question is United Nations. So UNEP's flagship report, Global Environmental Outlook report, has been recently released. So yes, we are done with your questions also. Here are your solutions. Tell your score. Let me know about your score. Okay. So we are done with your lecture. If you guys have any query, we would be happy to help you. You just need to drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. If you want to call us or even WhatsApp us, then our number is here in front of you, 8146207241. And you can also visit our website, www.edutab.co.in. And thank you guys for watching this video, and we'll be coming up with other videos also. Keep revising, keep learning. Wishing you all a very happy learning from our team, EduTap. See you in the next video, guys.